JPEG images suffer from lossy compression, resulting in a degradation of image quality, especially noticeable in areas with sharp edges or fine details. So, need to be in limits while editing JPEGs compared to RAWs, where there are a lot of details which can be recovered, though there are some tricks to make JPEGs look good. I have this JPEG imported to Lightroom. First, in Light menu, increasing the shadows to recover details in darker areas, but need to be careful not to overdo it, as especially in JPEGs, not lot of details can be recovered. Similarly, reducing highlights for details in brighter areas. If we overdo it, there is a possibility of getting halos around the sharp edges. So here, stopping around 30, making sure there are no sharp bright lines noticeable around the edges. Little decrease in exposure. Bit of contrast, adding just a bit of whites to make the brightest parts more brighter. Similarly, reducing blacks which affects darkest parts a bit. Now going to color menu and HSL sliders in color menu mix. Here, starting with the greens, moving the green hues just a bit towards yellows as the unique colors changes the green hues. Also reducing saturation too. Moving the yellow hues towards orange. Now to the blues. You can see where the blues are affected. Affecting the haze around the background hill. We'll reduce the luminance to limit the haze. Also desaturating it completely. Now going to healing menu and with the remove option, brushing on this tone to remove it. Next to the selective filters. I'm going to start with the radial filter. Making an oval shape around this brighter part of the sky will make the feather softer by increasing it to 100% and invert it. So the edits now affects only the outer parts of the radial filter. Here in light menu of the filter, reducing the exposure. Now we'll select sky with the select sky filter, which uses AI to select the sky. I only want to tune the horizon part of the sky here. So to remove the top parts of the sky from this filter, I'm gonna choose subtract from mask and select linear filter here, dragging the filter from top to around the horizon. This removes this part of the selection from the sky filter. You can see the exact mask selected now, where we are gonna add some colors to this. First, adding brightness by increasing exposure. Going to color menu, adding orangish tones to this part. Also increasing saturation. Also temperature and a bit of tint gives this evening colors to the horizon. Now I will duplicate the filter and reset all the sliders. Now inverting the mask, which now selects the rest of the parts of the image other than the horizon, darkening this by reducing the exposure. Also the whites a bit. Just a bit of orangish tone. Also reducing saturation. This has, of course, affected the bottom areas too. So we'll subtract the selection with a linear filter and add it to the foreground part of the image. We'll add a separate linear gradient filter at around here at the bottom and reduce the brightness. Adding another radial filter around the brighter part of the horizon. Adding brightness here, some orangish tones and more saturation. We'll add some haze by sliding the dehaze slider in the effects menu, reducing texture and clarity too. There is one edit we can do here. We'll add a small oval shaped filter. In the light menu, increasing whites to the maximum to make it pop. Adding saturation for some colors gives a subtle pop effect. One linear filter for the foreground. Making it contrasty by reducing blacks and adding whites. This also gives some sharpness to the foreground, which is nearer to the camera. Going back to the color menu, adding saturation and overall vibrance to the image. In the color grade menu, adding warmer orangish tones to the highlights. Just a hint of cooler tones to the shadows. And in the global settings, adding just a bit of orangish tones to the overall image. Tuning the overall contrast in curves, lifting the blacks just a bit. If we zoom, you can see the drawbacks of editing the JPEGs. Some artifacts in the sky, which is quite distracting. A trick to remove them. Going back to the masking filter where the top part of the sky was selected, here we'll remove the clarity and texture, which makes the artifacts disappear in the sky. So here's the before and after. Hope these tips were useful to you all, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.